I don't think I would have done anything differently. I had a charter. I had a guidebook, the Stratton Commission guidebook, and you just put one foot in front of the other and try to bring it about.
It's my pleasure at this time to introduce Dr. Robert M. White, Acting Administrator of the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. Dr. White.
Thank you, Captain Hollis. This is the first public official ceremony of our new administration, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. I'm very proud as the acting administrator to be able, of course, to participate in this. We view this as a sort of symbolic occasion in which we are launching this new organization whose mission will be to explore and study and understand, develop and conserve both our ocean and our atmospheric resources.
From the day President Richard Nixon created the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration in 1970, the influence of Dr. Robert M. White has been felt throughout the agency. A meteorologist by training, Dr. White was appointed by President John F. Kennedy to serve as chief of the U.S. Weather Bureau in 1963. The challenge then, as today, was to utilize technology to modernize the delivery of weather information. 2 years later, the visionary Dr. White collaborated with other Commerce Department colleagues to create the Environmental Science Services Administration, and he was named administrator of the agency, the precursor to NOAA. White, along with many esteemed colleagues, served as a member of the original Stratton Commission, which developed a coordinated, comprehensive policy for the responsible use and stewardship of the nation's ocean and coastal resources. As NOAA's first administrator, Dr. White left an indelible imprint on the agency, drawing together elements of both atmospheric and oceanic research that today are the hallmark of NOAA's unique federal mission of science, service, and stewardship to the nation.
The development of the Earth orbiting satellite, the development of radar, the development of the computers to actually process the data and make the forecasts were all things that was clear needed to be introduced into the Weather Service. If forecasts were to be more accurate, they would be more timely, the time range of the forecast would be extended. And so it was a systematic approach to trying to do that. And each director of the Weather Service and each administrator of NOAA has recognized the implications of these new technologies for the Weather Service, and each person in his own way introduced the things that were appropriate at that time. I was privileged to be there when a number of things were introduced and took steps to get them introduced. But the Weather Service of today is a totally different Weather Service than the one I was involved in getting started. It is a remarkable organization capable of doing things that were unheard of at the time that our Weather Service was being developed.
Dr. White's influence on the atmospheric side of NOAA is well known, but equally important is his realized vision of putting the proverbial O back in NOAA. During his 7 years at the helm of NOAA, he oversaw the enactment of several critical pieces of ocean legislation. Under his leadership, NOAA pursued the management of the nation's fisheries under what is today the Magnuson-Stevens Fisheries Management Conservation Act. 1972 was a banner year for the fledgling agency with the passage of the Marine Mammal Protection Act. Dr. White involved himself directly in these important issues, serving as the U.S. representative to the International Whaling Commission. At the same time, the Coastal Zone Management Act was passed, with NOAA and the states working actively to conserve and manage this important interface between land and sea. And finally, in 1972, the Marine Protection Research and Sanctuaries Act was passed.
Well, there was one piece of advice I used to espouse to the staff when we were gathered together in staff conferences at NOAA. Politics will come and politics will go. Ideas will come and ideas will go. And there's only one constant that you can hold on to, and that's the constant of science and technology. And if you adhere to the principles of good science, good technology, and steer clear of political involvements, NOAA will thrive.